Hello students, welcome once again to Bioinformatics class. In this class, we are going to discuss more about eukaryotic genomes. As per the syllabus, we will discuss about GC content and gene density in this video. GC content in eukaryotic genomes. Overall genomic GC content does not show the same variability between eukaryotic species as is observed in prokaryotes. It does seem to play a much more important role in gene recognition algorithms, though for at least two reasons. One, eukaryotic open read frames are much harder to recognize. And two, large scale variation of GC content within eukaryotic genomes underlies useful correlations between genes and upstream promoter sequences, codon choices, gene length, and gene density. CpG islands. One of the first bioinformatics analysis ever performed on DNA sequence data was statistical evaluation of the frequency that all possible pairs of nucleotides, that is GG, GA, GT, GC, AG, etc., were observed in generic sequences from the human genome. A striking observation was made. CG dinucleotides, that is often called CpGs, to reflect the phosphodiester bond that connects the two nucleotides. So the striking observation was that CG dinucleotides were found with only 20% of the frequency that should have occurred by chance. No other pair of nucleotides was found to be unusually over or underrepresented. The CpG site or CG sites are regions of DNA where a cytosine nucleotide is followed by guanine nucleotide in the linear sequence of bases along its 5' to 3' direction. CpG is the shorthand for 5' C phosphate G 3', that is cytosine and guanine separated by only one phosphate group. Phosphate links any two nucleotides together in DNA. CpG notation is used to distinguish this single-stranded linear sequence from the CG base pairing of cytosine and guanine for double-stranded sequences. CpG islands or CG islands are regions with high frequency of CpG sites. Though objective definitions of CpG islands are limited, the usual formal definition is a region with at least 200 base pairs, a GC percentage greater than 50%, and an observed to expected CpG ratio greater than 60%. The observed CpG ratio can be calculated as number of C plus number of G divided by 2 whole square divided by length of the sequence. Many genes in mammalian genomes have CpG islands associated with the start of the gene, that is promoter regions. Because of this, the presence of CpG island is used to help in the prediction and annotation of genes. Analysis of the complete human genome sequence indicate that there are approximately 45,000 such islands. That is, about 70% of human promoters have high CpG content. Analysis of human genome sequence also indicates around 22,000, that is around half of the islands, are associated with every known housekeeping gene. That is, the genes that are expressed at high levels in all tissues and at all times in development. Many of the remaining CpG islands appear to be associated with promoters of tissue-specific genes, although less than 40% of non-tissue-specific genes have them. CpG islands are only rarely found in gene-free regions or with genes that have accumulated inactive mutations. Now, let us understand the term methylation with GC content in eukaryotic genome. CpG islands are intimately associated with an important chemical modification of DNA in most eukaryotes. We call it as methylation. A specific enzyme, DNA methylase, is known to attach methyl groups to the nitrogenous base cytosine, as shown in this figure. But only when it occurs in 5-CG3- dinucleotides. Methylation itself seems to be responsible for the rarity of CpGs in the genome as a whole, since methylated cytosines are known to be especially prone to mutation. DNA methylation typically acts to repress gene transcription. DNA methylation is essential for normal development and is associated with a number of key processes, including genomic imprinting, X chromosome inactivation, repression of transposable elements, aging, and carcinogenesis. Histones are unusually positively charged, well-conserved proteins found within eukaryotes that have a high affinity for negatively charged DNA molecules. The roughly equal mixture by mass of DNA and closely associated histones within eukaryotic nuclei is called chromatin. Wrapping of DNA around histones and further organization of the histones themselves results in a final packaging ratio of approximately 1:10,000 for eukaryotic genomic DNA. Transcriptionally active regions are generally areas where the positive charge of histones is reduced by the addition of acetyl and methyl groups. The resulting low affinity of those histones for negatively charged DNA causes the chromatin to be less tightly packed and more accessible to RNA polymerases. Such areas of open chromatin are known as euchromatin, in contrast to transcriptionally inactive densely packed heterochromatin. Information stored in heterochromatin is not lost, but is much less likely to be used in gene expression, much like the way information in textbook is much less likely to be accessed if the book is packed away in a box in an attic. The packaging of DNA differs significantly from one cell type to another, and genomic sequence information, aside from CpG islands, gives only hints as to what a region's chromatin structure will be. Among those hints is what can be gleaned from isochore compartmentalization, which is described next. Isochores. The genomes of almost all eukaryotes display evidence of a level of organization called isochore that is intermediate between that of genes and chromosomes. The working definition of isochore is long regions of homogeneous base composition, which has two operative parts. First, the genomic sequences of isochores are in excess of 1 million base pairs in length. Second, the GC content of an isochore is relatively uniform throughout. Although it differs significantly as the transition is made from one isochore to the next. An isochore is a large region of DNA greater than 300 kb with high degree uniformity in guanine and cytosine, that is GC and CG. These putative isochores are non-uniformly scattered throughout the genome and cover about 41% of the human genome. The higher the GC content, the higher the melting point of the DNA. GC-rich DNA sequences are more stable than sequences with low GC content, but contrary to the popular belief, the hydrogen bonds are not the primary reason for this stability. The higher the GC content, the higher the gene density. Human chromosome suggests that there are five classes of isochore called H1, H2, and H3 with 46%, 49%, and 54%, and L1, L2 with 39% and 42% GC content. Codon usage bias. GC content of synonymous codons profoundly influences amino acid usage. Some of the biological basis for these preferences may be related to avoidance of codons that are similar to stop codons, as well as preference for codons that allow efficient translation because they correspond to particularly abundant tRNAs within the organism. Codon usage in plants has been less extensively studied, but there are reports of translationally selected codon usage bias in some species. Viruses of eukaryotes often have biased codon usage, but it appears to be generally due to mutation biases rather than the influence of natural selection. Now, eukaryotic gene density. Gene density of a genome is a measure of the number of genes per million base pairs, called a megabase MB. Prokaryotic genomes have much higher gene densities than eukaryotes. The human genome has a gene density of 12 to 15 genes per megabase, while the genome of a C. elegans roundworm is estimated to have 200 genes per megabase. So when we learn the size, genes and density, there are many informations. Eukaryotes have larger genomes than bacteria, but plants contains the largest sets of genes. But gene density tells a different story because of the non-coding DNA. Coding for proteins and RNA products is only a tiny portion of the genome. Bulk of genomes is mostly non-coding or junk DNA, but they may have important role to persist for hundreds of generations. For example, human genome has 500 to 1500 more base pairs in DNA compared to bacteria, but only 5 to 15 times more genes.